Please subscribe mat.com and don't forget to hit the bell icon for more video updates. Hello everyone. Today we will learn how you can find the adjoint of a matrix having three rows and three columns, or you can say 3×3 matrix, or the matrix of order n greater than or equal to 3. It means once you came to know how to find the adjoint of a matrix of order 3×3, then it will be easier for you to find the adjoint of any matrix of order n is equals to 3 or greater than 3. It means you can also find the adjoint of a 4×4 matrix, 5×5 matrix by the same method. So we'll start with the method of finding the adjoint of a 3×3 matrix. There will be two steps you will be used to find the adjoint of a 3×3 matrix. So step number one is find the cofactors. Now what are the cofactors? We will start with the easiest method today here for your ease, how you can find the adjoint of a 3×3 matrix, as we are given with a matrix. Now its cofactor matrix will be Aij, where I is the row and j is the column, 3×3, as we have a 3×3 matrix, equals to, so this is a cofactor matrix. Now how you can find this cofactor matrix? Basically this A11, A12, A13, these are all the cofactors. So cofactors are basically the signed minors. We can also write this matrix as cofactors are the signed minors. It means you must have the knowledge about the signs, what will be the signs with the cofactors. So it is very important to know that signs will be like, first you will have plus sign, then minus, then minus, then plus, then minus, then plus, then minus, and plus, minus, and plus. And if you have a matrix of order 4×4, then it will carry on by adding one row and one column on the sides. So these are the signs. It means as the cofactors are the signed minors, it means we need signs, and then we have to multiply it with the minor. And what is minor? We will find the minors one by one. I have also discussed in the previous lectures what is minor and how to find the minor. So I'll write here as with the plus as plus M11. This is the minor of the element at location 11, that is at this location. Then we have minus M12. This is the minor of the element as at this location. Plus M13. This is the minor of the element at this location. How we will find? I'll discuss it later. So this is the cofactor matrix, in which we have to find the cofactors. Cofactors are the signed minors. We have decided the signs. We have written the signs here, and the minors are multiplied. Now let's see how you can find the minors. I have also discussed it in the previous lectures that how you can find the minors, and we will write it in detail here again, one by one, how you can find M11, M12, M13, and so on. So we'll start with M11. We will find the minors, and I'll put the values of M11, M12, M13 in this cofactor matrix, and we will carry on. So this is the first step in which we have to find the cofactors. So M11 is equals to, this is the element of which cofactor, of which minor we are going to find. So this is the element. So minor is the determinant obtained by deleting the row and column in which that element lies. It means we are going to delete the row and column of this element. As we are going to find the minor of 3, so we have to delete the row and column in which the 3 lies, and to take the determinant of the rest of the elements. So let's take the determinant as, I have to write here as 2, 5, 4 and 1. And its determinant, we can find its determinant multiplying the diagonal and subtracting them together as we do in 2×2 matrix. So it will be 2 minus 20 equals to minus 18. So M11 is minus 18. So we need to put this value here. Then we have to find the value of M12. Let's see what will be. It will be M12 is equals to, in case of M12, we have this element. 2 is the minor of the element at location first row and second column. It means this minus 1. We have to find the minor of this element. So in such a case, we have to delete this row and this column, and then take the determinant of the rest of the elements. That is 2, 1, 4, 1. What will be the determinant? It will be 2 minus 4. Equals to minus 2. Similarly, we have to find the minor of the element at one first row and third location, that is this element. So how it will be then? We have, as this is the element, so we have to delete the row and column of this element and find the determinant of the rest of the elements. As right here, the rest of the elements as 2, 1, 2, 5, and what we will get is 10 minus 2 multiplying the diagonal and dividing that two and subtracting them together equals to 8. So we have found M11, M12, M13. Then similarly, we can minor of 2, 1, that is the element at this location. So we have to
delete the row and column of this element, and what left is we have to take the determinant of the rest of the elements as minus 1, 2, 5 and 1 equals to minus 1, minus 10 equals to minus 11. Similarly, we can find the minor of M22, M23, minor of M22 equals to, if I do it quickly, as this is the element. So we have to delete this row and this column and to take the rest of the elements. And so the determinant found by rest of the elements will be 3 minus 2. 3 minus 2. Equals to 1. Then we will have M23. For M23 we will choose another color, as M23 is the element at this location. So we have to delete this column and this row, and to find the determinant of the rest of the elements, as 10 plus 1 equals to 16. Then M31 is equals to the element at this location. So accordingly we will delete this row and this column, and we have to find the determinant of the rest of the elements as minus 4 minus 4 equals to minus 8. Then we have M32. M32 is the element at this location. So delete this row and this column. What we will get is 12 minus 4 equals to 8. Then lastly, we have the element at M33, of which minor we are going to find is this one. So we have to delete the row and column of this one, and we have to find the determinant of the rest of the elements as 6 plus 2 will be 6 plus 2 equals to 8. So we have got the minors of all the elements. So we will put these values in this matrix, this cofactor matrix. So it will be like, if I use a different color, plus M11. So plus, what is M11? M11 is minus 18. It means it will be minus 18. Then we have the M12 as minus 2. So it will be minus into minus 2. Then we have the M13 as 8. It will be as plus 8. Then minus M21 is minus 11. So minus into minus 11. Then we have plus here, and M22 is 1. Then we have minus here, and M23 is 16. Then we have plus here, and M31 is minus 8. Then we have negative here, and M32 is 8. Then we have plus here, and M33 is 8. So this is the cofactor matrix, that is Aij 3 into 3. So this is the step number 1. So step number 1 ends here. It means we have found a co-matrix. We have found a cofactor matrix. Now the step number 2 is we have to take the transpose of this matrix. So the step number 2 is we have to take the transpose of this cofactor matrix that we have found. So we will write here, adjoint of A will be equals to Aij transpose. T for transpose, 3 into 3 matrix. And let's see what we will get is the adjoint of a 3 into 3 matrix. So let's find the transpose of 3 into 3 matrix here, as what we will get is, in transpose we change the rows into column and columns into rows. So what we will get is minus 18, first column will become row, plus 11 minus 8. Then the second column will become row, plus 2 plus 1 minus 8. And then third column will become row, plus 8 minus 16 and plus 8. So this is the adjoint of a 3 into 3 matrix. So that's all from today's lecture. This is how you can find the adjoint of a 3 into 3 matrix. So stay tuned for the next lecture, in which we will see how you can find the inverse of a 3 into 3 matrix by using this the concept of adjoint. So that's all from today's lecture. Thank you.